I will give now the the presentation to Thies Mokki from Twence. He, as we have heard already about biorefineries now, of course we will need feedstocks for this third generation biorefineries. And Thies is working as project engineer in Twence. Twence is, you will give a short overview about Twence anyway. It's a waste treatment company, but they're not only treating waste, they are all the time looking for, let's say recycling, valorizing their things. So I will give now to Thies. Do you want to make the presentation? Yes. Okay. Thies, you can share then.
Okay, can you see my presentation?
Yes, I can see it.
Okay, good. Then let's start. Good morning, everybody. My name is Thies Mokki, as Thomas already mentioned. I'm working at the company of Twence. Twence is indeed a waste treatment facility in the east of the Netherlands, close to the city of Enschede, for who knows it. Yes, Twence also took part in the Horizon 2020 Volatile project. And as said, we are a waste treatment facility. So as Jochen mentioned, the third generation biorefineries mostly work on residual feedstocks, and residuals is what we are good at. So today I will talk to you about these feedstocks, residual feedstocks for third generation biorefineries. But first, I'd like, as already mentioned, to introduce my company a bit. We are a company. We produce raw materials and sustainable energy from waste streams, biomass, and other renewable sources. We try to do this in an optimal fashion. So we try to optimal process the waste and the biomass streams. As I will show in the next slide, there's lots of options and possibilities for synergy between plants. And we try to be involved locally and to be active internationally to work within this project of the volatile. That's a good example of that. First, some basic figures. At our company, about 240 people work. Our net turnover is about 115 million euros per year. And the net profit every year is about 14 to 15 million euros. So in this sheet, you see an overview of our location. Now you might understand that synergy is really possible in and around our location. Here at the center is our main business. These are three incineration lines for municipal solid waste. So it's incinerated the municipal solid waste to create energy, so energy, steam and heat. And also here within this bottom ash reprocessing plant, we create some metals and bottom ashes, which are also products coming from the waste. To have an idea of synergy, you see a steam pipe flowing, going to the left side of the picture. This is where we transport steam to our neighboring company, Nurion. Maybe people know it. They produce salts from salt mines below the earth, below the soil. And they use our energy for their process. So that's a nice combination of our products and their process. On the right of the picture here, you see our biomass power plant. Here we treat biomass waste, woody waste. In this case, it's mostly coming, it's all coming from demolition of buildings. This wood is then incinerated into heat, energy, and steam and electricity. Furthermore, what we have on our location here is a materials recycling facility. Here we separate, for instance, plastics, wood, metals from demolition and building demolition waste. Furthermore, we have a large landfill area which still produces biogas. And I think for today it's nice to also mention this part here on the top left of the image, which is our composting and digestion facility. Every year we receive about 100 to 150,000 tons of garden fruit and vegetable waste from the cities in the neighborhood. And we compost this material here. We have two digesters, one for the solid organic waste and one for wet waste. I'm sorry. There we go. Here's the image back again. And we produce then biogas from three entities, so the landfill and the two digesters, and from that we produce electricity and heat, and the heat is then transported to the heating of civilians within the area. So there's some cities nearby and we transport the heat for heating purposes of houses. So to have an idea of the material that we process, here's some numbers. About 600,000 tons per year of RDF we incinerate and treat. And as you can see, biomass for composting and anaerobic digestion is about 150,000 tons per year. From this, I also show the output here. So from this municipal waste, we produce almost 20,000 tons of metals and 140 to 150,000 tons of bottom ashes, which are used, for instance, for road construction, the fundamental part of the fundaments of the road. Also, 50,000 tons of compost is produced yearly. And here you also see some figures about the energy we produce and the CO2 and use of natural gas, which we avoid with our activities. This image shows the amount of energy we produce yearly for the last 15 years. And it's nice to see that some projects which were built, you see the effect on the produced energy. For instance here, the biomass to energy plant was built and operational. Then the third incineration line for municipal waste was built here. Then we managed to build our heat and steam delivery to the Nouryon company, and so on and so on. And now you see we are at a very high level of more than 1300 gigawatt hours of energy production yearly. And as you can see, like 70% of this is coming from organic waste and is sustainable. So the products coming from the waste, here's a nice list of that. For instance, the compost and the metals I already mentioned. A very nice one to mention is the third one, the sodium bicarbonate. We have a plant, a small pilot plant, which uses about 4,000 tons of CO2 per year coming from the flue gas. And we make sodium bicarbonate from this, which we again use in our flue gas treatment system. So that's some nice synergy example, which is which we use at our company. Furthermore, we produce plastics, paper, and wood from some demolition waste. And lastly, it's good to mention the bottom ashes, which is a large volume every year, as I've mentioned, 150,000 tons of products per year. And we use that mostly these days in road construction. But in the future, it's a plan to produce freely usable material from this. It's also shown here in this sheet. Here you can see some activities, some projects we are working on for the future, and which are also our ambition. For instance, within the bioconversion, we are working basically on two projects, the project Volatile, which you hear about today, the whole day, But furthermore, we are also trying to find out if we can produce a biofuel from our organic waste, in this case a liquid natural gas, also called liquefied biogas, LBG. And we are trying to do this with some farmers in our regional area. Furthermore, we are planning to build a manure valorization plant on a different location of ours, where we produce biogas, but then produce from this the biomethane, which we can directly add to the natural gas system within the Netherlands. We are planning to build a full-scale CO2 capturing plant for reuse, so CCU plant. And maybe it's also again good to mention this Green Deal of the bottom ashes, where we within the near future should make freely usable material from these ashes. So enough about Twents. I'm sorry, sometimes it just shows a part of the sheet. Back to the feedstocks for the third generation biorefineries. Twents had the lead on at least one of the work packages, for instance work package one, where with some partners within the project we wanted to find out about the feedstocks, and we performed a desk study, and I will show you some of the results of this desk study today. And I will finalize with some pictures of work package three, where we built a pilot plant in which we try to concentrate the VFAs. Why did Twents take place in this project? Here you see a roadmap of our company for our bio-based resources. As you see, we already have our bioconversion. We are planning the manure digestion facility to make manure and compost. But for the future, we also plan to work towards higher value products. In this case, of course, we are talking about biochemicals, platform chemicals. And here you see the position of the volatile project within our roadmap. We also work on waste to aromatics, biorefineries, biomass gasification and pyrolysis, and volatile as a perfect position next to these activities. So that's why we entered the volatile project. So work package one, the target was to find out all there is to know about feedstocks within EU 28, so the 28 countries within the EU. We were trying to find out about the availability of the organic waste, the organic fraction of municipal solid waste, and wastewater treatment plant sludge. Also, we tried to find out about waste collection methods, performed SWOT analysis on that, current technologies for treatment. We also tried to find out about that. And furthermore, we found out about the feedstock analysis, market demand, and we performed several case studies. This is too much to show you today within the limited time I have, so I will focus on several parts of what you see here. First, the desk study. In the right of this picture, you see a very nice table where for different countries, you see the amount of waste used and separately collected and biologically treated for different 28 countries within the EU. For instance, it's nice to see that out of the total produced waste, for instance in Belgium, the vegetable garden and fruit waste, about 311 tons yearly are separately collected. And also 580 tons of green waste. Think about clippings from the side of the road and that kind of green waste. So you see a total of organic separately collected waste, and OF, organic fraction of municipal solid waste, is 1800 tons per year in Belgium. And out of this, this amount is biologically treated. If we look then at the totals, one can see that within the EU 28, there's 36 million tons per year available for of vegetable garden and fruit waste, also green waste. There is 60 million tons of organic fraction within the municipal solid waste, so this is not yet separated, available. And there's 9 to 10 million tons per year of sludge available. This makes up a total of 105 million tons per year, which is, yeah, simply said, a huge amount. Only 35% of this organic waste is then treated separately, like within composting treatment and or anaerobic digestion. And 8% of the total collected organic waste is anaerobically digested. These are quite low numbers, so simply said, there's still potential for more, in this case, maybe even for the VFA platform. To summarize, this 8% of, there's a methane potential of about 4.4 to 7.2 billion cubic meters. If we look at the collection of waste, I think on the left there's a nice table which shows the different types of collection. And you see for different countries how they are collecting their different kind of waste. Maybe again, Belgium here is a very good example, because in Belgium you see paper and biowaste are separately collected door to door, while other fraction like glass, plastics, metals are commingled, collected, so to say. And if we look at a different country like the Czech Republic, you see that all the civilians have to bring this kind of waste to bring points or civic amenity sites. So you can see that within all different countries, different kind of collection methods are used, depending on population density and other kind of regional or topographic reasons. If we then focus on the biowaste, you should look at the picture on the right. You see that there are countries, for instance, the dark green ones, where there's a separate collection and composting or digestion of biowaste taking place. In other countries, the green countries that are shown here, there's a separate collection of biowaste in preparation or implementation. And there's also many countries, the gray ones, where only limited collection of biowaste takes place. So also for separately collecting this kind of biowaste, there's still a large potential available. Here a small list of the different treatment technologies that are being performed and taking place in the different countries, again depending on different kind of reasons. For instance, the population density is a very important one in this case. Landfilling, incineration, mechanical biological treatment, industrial composting, home composting, and anaerobic digestion are the most important treatment technologies that are being used in Europe. Then on to the case studies. About 8 different case studies have been performed. Here you see the partners which were involved in these case studies. So these partners were, I think, all also taking part in the volatile project. In these case studies, we look mostly at these variables, the region and distances, so the logistics, the different kind of technologies which are used, and the level of treatment. Of course, the potential for the VFA production integration and availability of fermentation industry in the area. So here a very small summary of the results. Transport distances are on average 75 kilometers. And transport distances, I mentioned then the transport distances for input and output of these plants. Of course, a large range is found from 30 to 150 kilometers, and 150 kilometers is a large distance to transport your input for, but it does happen. If we look at the treatment of the organic waste, then the pre-treatment that takes place is mostly sieving in a range of 40 to 60 millimeters. The treatment, the most important treatment is that the small fractions are often anaerobically digested, while the larger fractions are mostly composted or even treated in a waste treatment facility, often waste to energy. The post-treatment, often you see that a sieving step takes place, and a small fraction, often smaller than 12 millimeters, is then composted into nice products. If we look into the treatment of sludge, there you see sieving mostly takes place at 6 millimeters, and treatment by anaerobic digestion takes place, after which dewatering and drying takes place. Capacity is on average 76 kiloton per year, in a range of 30 to 125 kilotons. The most important and intriguing result is that the net result of these facilities vary between -4 to +10 euros per ton of input. So there are companies that don't make a profit per ton. And this proves that there's a large potential for making higher value products out of this input, out of this waste, and improving this net result of the different companies. So I would like to finalize with some pictures of the pilot plant we built at our location. First, let me show you a picture of the wet digester at Twence. The digestion mostly takes place in this semi-sphere in the back. There the biogas is produced, but we placed a reactor, a VFA reactor, close to this digester, and we took some of the insides of the digester before methanization took place, and we put it in this reactor to produce the VFA material. This reactor in the product we put into a membrane filtration unit. And this pilot plant is built and used together with two partners, in this case OWS from Belgium and Technalia. And here you see the different colleagues and partners involved. One can conclude that we successfully concentrated the VFA, and VFA concentrate was produced. So the general conclusions to summarize: there's a huge potential of organic waste within the EU28. As I mentioned, this is about 105 million tons of organic waste per year. Only 35% of this waste, this organic waste, is biologically treated, and 8% is treated by anaerobic digestion. So there's still large amounts of organic waste which can be treated first by AD and composting, but even it is available for this VFA platform. And what is still a bit troubling, 25% of the municipal solid waste is still landfilled within the EU28. We do see that increasing amounts of biowaste are separately collected, but still 50% of the municipal solid waste is organic. So we should focus also on this separate collection of the biowaste. From the case studies, as I mentioned, the net results are varying between -4 and +10 euros per ton input. So there's also lots of opportunities to improving this net result, for instance, then by producing very volatile fatty acids and other kinds of high value products from this waste. And I would conclude with that implementing the VFA pilot at Twence was indeed successful. So yeah, if you do have questions which are not answered today or at this moment, then of course you're free to email me or my colleague, as you see here, and I'd like to thank you for your attention. So Thomas, back to you.
Hi Thies. Yeah, thank you very much for the presentation. It was quite interesting. Lawrence has a question, but I think that will be answered later on. He is asking how much VFE could be produced by a ton of input material. But as we have the specific presentation from Philip, really focusing on this transformation rate, I would postpone this. I hope Lawrence's response already said that's okay for him. So okay, good. Are there any other questions for Thies? No, it looks not. Anyway, if you have later on questions, that will be, you can all the time. Samson is asking up to what level was the VFE concentrated with the membrane. Also, this we will answer, Samson, later on, because we have the specific volatile fatty acid platform presentation. Yes. So there. Yeah. Anyway, I can also give you later on there some further information on that. Okay.
Good.
Okay. Then, Thies, thanks a lot.
Welcome.
And then I will give now the